Hello, YouTubers. This is the Noobifier. I've been busy on course, away from home, and holding off providing my opinion with regards to the Forbes article. I find it unlikely that by now you don't know what I'm talking about. However, before I start, Forbes magazine published an article, and it didn't paint a very positive picture of Chris Roberts. People always say that there's no such thing as bad publicity, but I believe this went a little bit beyond. As a backer, it's frustrating to see our complex universe be examined just as a business with a narrow field of view. What I hope to achieve today is an objective look, which means that I'm going to bury my personal bias and look at the subject, then present some of what I've found. So now, as others have done before, it's my turn to share with you, is Forbes bullshit or not, by the numbers. Let's begin. I backed Star Citizen because of one man's audacity. What was pitched sounded exactly like something that I wanted to play. In 2013, I was prepared to lose $45 on what seemed to be a long shot, because to me, it was no different than buying a lottery ticket. To their credit, CIG has always emphasized that the extra ships are available to those who want to support and are not needed to play. Despite this from the outside, people will always see predatory marketing or pay to win. Many others have been as or more critical about Star Citizen, but I would say that the Forbes article stands out. Forbes is generally respected within the business community and they seem to maintain a high standard. This article focuses on the CEO and the business practices of CIG, which I would say is appropriate based on where Forbes normally operates. Forbes itself isn't a very large company, so my first objective observation would be mutually assured destruction. Publishing a poorly researched segment based on sloppy journalism and assumptions would also damage their reputation. It could even put them into a large legal battle over defamation. You could say then, as an outsider, Forbes likely still stands by their article, and I expect it to release to print at the end of the month without retraction or modification. On the positive side, they confirm that Star Citizen isn't a scam because CIG is actually building the game. The article isn't negative towards the game project or the developers specifically. They care only about its CEO, the timelines, micromanagement, lack of focus, crushing delays, waste, and as they put it, mismanagement on a galactic scale. Forbes didn't hold anything back, jumping deep into Chris Roberts' past and even his personal life. As its target audience is the cutthroat business sector, in my research, this full expose on the CEO may seem to have gone too far, but it's actually not uncommon. Business appears to be even more cutthroat than politics. Everything is dug up, analyzed, cross-verified in an attempt to find weakness or faults. The veteran backers have an understanding of the entire project. We understand past failures like the Cutlass Mark I, and the eventual successes like Cutlass Mark II. Forbes isn't interested in any of that. They see money in, money out, potential, growth, results, stability, credibility, track record, and the most important, leadership from the top down. So, while still being objective, the article, although very personal, critical, and not flattering of the CEO, seems to be based on fact. I'd like to add my opinion at this point and move away from objective for a little bit. I believe basing the entire article on the opinions from a pool of 20 ex-employees likely resulted in a very pessimistic and incomplete view of the actual situation. I would have loved for them to reach out to the current section heads, and I think that the article might have benefited from a less biased perspective. I also believe that liberties may have been taken with some of the math, and I believe that Forbes may have purposely focused on the negative story, glossing over many of the accomplishments. The article is brutal, cold, personal, and critical of the CEO. Objectively, I think the article was a cheap shot, and as a backer, I come to the same conclusion. Not a bad piece of journalism, but conveniently an incomplete picture. I'm going to end with what I consider to be my key takeaway from this article. If you're a Star Citizen critic, very likely that you very much enjoyed the article's tone. If you're a Star Citizen backer and a fan of the project, between today and when the game goes live, remember that nothing matters except what you personally get out of your own journey. And by that I mean, people will bash the project in social media and people will call it a scam. You're the only one that you have to worry about. Between good and bad patches, between achievements or delays, I don't personally care what other people think. I choose to back the game and follow development. Just like a wedding day, both parties show up believing it's forever, despite the statistics. We know there's a real risk of failure due to complexity or even mismanagement. Just like everything in life, I accept the risk and then I hope for success. After launch, I think the titles Star Citizen Backer and Star Citizen Hater will just be replaced with Star Citizen. After launch, I hope to be too busy playing the game to argue over the pass. And there it is, short and sweet. This video took me a fair chunk of time to assemble what I was thinking into a compact video, so if you got something out of it, I'd ask please that you share it with your friends or orgmates. I'm just a backer like everyone else, and the subscribers here would love to hear your perspective in the comments. Fly safe, and I'll see you in the verse.